I'm going to tell you from a potential client's point of view why you don't reach us with your marketing, what we want as potential clients, and what we say about you when you're not here. Let's assume that you've carried out marketing. Let's assume that that marketing has been successful and it has resulted in an appointment in your diary to come and meet with me. Let's assume that me equals your grade B or grade A style client. Someone whom you would love to work with, someone where there's potential for more than just compliance work, someone who you understand to be perhaps a great fee opportunity for you as well, okay? This is essentially a date between you and me. We're going on a date together. Now, what happens if you arrive late for a date? Right, exactly, I don't need to answer that question, you've answered it yourself in the response. So late arrivals, even if you called me ahead of time, even if you told me you were gonna be late, I'm still thinking, oh, okay, first thing against it. How concerned are you really? How interested are you really about me and my business? So late arrivals is the first thing. The next thing is weak proposals. By weak proposals, you can also read quotations into this. I started this business that I am the founder of 3.5 years ago. Within the first 8 weeks, I received an approach from a firm of accountants. They met with me for 45 minutes. I received their proposal by email. Here, almost verbatim, for your pleasure, is the email I received. Dear Martin, because they couldn't get my name right either. Dear Martin, thank you very much for our meeting yesterday, which I very much enjoyed. And on the basis of our conversation, I'd like to propose that we, name of firm removed, become your new accountants for the fee of £8,000, roughly $12,000. For this, we will deliver bullet point one that I did not understand because it was in jargon. Bullet point two that I did not understand because it was in jargon, and you get the general idea. And if you are, and this is the killer, you're gonna love this part. If you are ready to accept, please reply to this email typing the word yes. No, Jacqueline, I'm not kidding, I'm deadly serious. In the body of the email, and we shall undertake work straight away. Yours sincerely, person who is never going to get my job as long as they've got a, you know. So that's what I mean by weak proposals. All other weak proposals is when we're looking for 25, 50,000 pound, dollar, euro style engagements, and we take a page and a half in which to propose a solution. First tip that I'm going to bring out in this presentation, make your proposals, please, commensurate with the level of fee that you're looking to win. If it is a low fee, it is a short proposal. If it is a substantial fee, there should be something to justify that level of investment from me. No follow-up is something that I imagine will resonate around this room. You come, you see me, we have a great first date, and then you don't call. We never hear from you again. Do you still love me? I don't know. I don't hear from you. Or you call, and I was busy, and I call you back, and you're busy, and you call me, and I'm busy, and I call you back, and you're busy, and then you give up, because it's just not worth it. Discounting, and I'll look at what I call lowballing in detail a little bit later on, discounting is a major, major problem for this profession. It's a cancer of this profession. The lowballing or discounting provokes doubt in our minds. It gives us a concern that you've overpriced something in the first place. It makes us think that you maybe are going to put juniors on my work and on my engagements, and it's not going to be you that I'm working with in too much detail. These are doubts that we have. However, nothing quite does it for us like the misspelling of our name. Such a small detail. Such a tiny little thing makes such a big difference. Now, when you go through life with a name like Martin Bissett, I can assure you the one thing you are never called is Martin Bissett. Generally, you go through your life as Malcolm Bishop. That is normally who I am. So I will call. Who's calling, please? Martin Bissett. Malcolm Bishop, that's correct. I thought, just sometimes I think about changing that around. Who's calling, please? Malcolm Bishop. Martin Bissett, that's correct. And, you know, I'm used to it, but many of us aren't. And many of us, our name is our key ident. And therefore, please get it right. It's what we're known by. It's the thing we like the sound of the most. So, Malcolm Bishop, also Martin Bassett, commonly known. Martin Griffiths is another one. But my favorite, again, no word of a lie, my favorite from someone who either just could not be bothered trying to get things right or had an outright hate campaign against me, felt that I should be called Morton Fishcakes. I received correspondence to Morton Fishcakes. I won't tell you what I did with it. We're in a polite audience today.